ladies and gentlemen, the first thing I got to have you do is get to Tinkercad. So type that in. And when you get to Tinkercad, hopefully it'll sign you in. If not, I need you to sign in. When you do that, I want you to create a new design. Click on the word design and change its properties instead of the goofy name. Change it to car with your name or your initials. And then save your changes. We're going to start our car with a box. And then I'm also going to teach you some cool tools as we do it. When you get the box in, I want you to orient it so it lands right on the grid in some shape like that, so it's right on a corner. Then I want you to click the ruler tab and put the ruler tool and put the little dot right on the corner. The next time you click the box, it puts in values, and I want you to change your car's body to 10 high. I want you to click on the length of it, and I want you to make it 40. And then I want you to click the width of it, and I want you to make it 25. So what I'm showing you is that you can type in amounts as you design something. When you've got your car like that, move on to the next step. Let's practice that work plane tool again, where you click the work plane and set it to the top of the car. We're going to put the roof on our car right now. You can do your roof a little different than me if you want, but I want a cube to be on top of my previous cube. And then this time I'm going to go old school, and I'm going to just grab and drag the black handles to make it the size that fits the car. And then to make it look more like a car, I am going to use the very cool wedge and drop one of those in front. Spin it around. Remember, if you move in to the thick lines, it snaps to the numbers that are more akin to what you would like. You can see here I'm stretching and adjusting it till it fits my design plan. Then I'm going to do the very cool duplicate trick so that I've got two of these. By hitting edit and then duplicate. And then if I rotate that around, you'll see that there are two in the same spot. I want to get that so it's using those snappy lines in the middle for the 180. And I'm going to drag it to the back of my car. And I had told you initially I had measurements I wanted for the car. That was just to show you how we could adjust things. Once you do that, you can click W, and then you can say, you know what, I want my car to be a little longer or shorter, and stretch and adjust till you're happy with it. At that point, move on to the next piece of our car training. At this point, I want you to spin around, and let's add some headlights, once again using that cool work plane, which you can click on the work plane or just use the letter W like I did. And I want my headlights to be circles. And then I'm going to go to the measurement corner, and I'm going to hold shift and shrink them down till they're nice and small, the size I want my headlights to be. I like that diameter. Now I can place it where I want. I'm going to orbit and look at it from the side, and I decided just now that that's sticking out there way too far for what I want. And then I'm going to do edit, duplicate again. And I'm going to drag its duplicate over to the other side so that I'm happy. Real quickly, I've added two cool headlights. You can add whichever style you want, and then move on. I have left the work plane on. If you shut yours off, you can turn it back on. And right now, I want to add a bumper. I'm going to choose to have my bumper like this. And here you've got a good view of me using the long lines when I rotated that. I want my bumper to be thinner. You can, of course, use a different kind of bumper for yours, or maybe even add something special instead of a bumper. I'm a little flexible, but I want you to combine that work plane tool and more round shapes to make something cool in the front of your car. And then move on. All right, with our bumpers added, now let's add some cool wheels real quick. Use that W or the work plane button to put the work plane on the side of the car. Pull out a cylinder to make it a wheel. Hold down the shift button and grab a handle and shrink it down to a size that you think fits your car. Shrink it in to about 3 or 4 millimeters. And then I'm going to use this tool to push it into my car so that it's attached. I'm going to do edit, and I'm going to do duplicate to make a second wheel. I'm going to pull that second wheel straight back. Making sure that they're lined up the same height. So now they are. I'm going to hold down shift, and I'm going to group those. And then I'm going to duplicate those. With them duplicated, you want to use this cool handle to just move them to the other side. I moved mine one chunk too far, I believe, so I'm going to just pull them back so they're sunk into the car just like the others were. And right there, you've used the awesome work plane tool and the duplicate tool and the group tool to get your car so it has four wheels. At this point, go on to the next step. At this point, you can just start adding cool things that you want. I do want you to be wary of this saving button. If you add two pieces before it's finished and it's locked in that position, the only thing I can find that you can do is press F5 on the keyboard to refresh it, but then it backs you up to the last piece that it had saved. So just be wary of that little saving as your creations get more and more complex. Have fun and happy tinkering. And when you're finished, make sure you publish and share with me at HL ModTech so I can see the cool things that your creations turned out to be.